In this lecture, we will be seeing the resistive load inverters. Okay, so we have already seen there are different type of inverters, and that inverter depends on the type of load we have used or we are going to use. Okay, so in this lecture, we will be seeing the resistive load to an inverter. So this will be the circuit. Okay, so this is your load part. So we are going to have a resistor as a load, and this is an NMOS, that is enhancement type NMOS. Okay, so all the circuits we will be studying in the next couple of PPTs or lectures. Whenever we are talking about transistors, we are basically going to have enhancement type transistor. Okay. So we will be talking about enhancement type NMOS or enhancement type PMOS. Okay. So we will be going through these two types of MOSFETs. So we will be only using enhancement type. So why we prefer to use enhancement type MOSFETs only? Yes, anyone is having any idea, like why for practical purposes we only go for enhancement type MOSFETs like NMOS or PMOS? Okay, so we go for enhancement type MOSFETs because in depletion type MOSFETs we require extra fabrication steps. Okay, so fabrication of DMOS is quite complex. That's why we prefer to use enhancement type MOSFETs. Okay, so we will be using enhancement type MOSFET only. So here this is an NMOS. Okay, and input is provided at the gate terminal of NMOS, and output is taken from the drain terminal, and drain terminal is connected to the resistor that is load and which is connected to VDD. So this is the circuit diagram. Okay, and for the operation, so this will be the operation range, like how the voltage range will be depending. So once we are increasing the gate voltage, okay, so gate voltage will be in the form of, for DC analysis, whenever we are going for a DC analysis, the gate voltage will be like first. Yes, so gate voltage will be increasing with respect to time, we will be increasing. So this is VGS, gate voltage. So once we are increasing gate voltage, okay, so this is straight gate voltage, the continuous. Okay, so up to a particular voltage, suppose this is VT0, that is VT0 is your threshold voltage of the MOSFET. Okay, and furthermore, so once the gate voltage is less than threshold voltage, this region will be considered as your cutoff region. The next will be, once we are increasing the gate voltage in the DC analysis, we will be increasing gate voltage in a linear form. Okay, from starting from 0 to up to a VDD point, what is the maximum point up to. Okay, so there will be a different mode of operation with respect to your gate voltage. So once we are increasing the gate voltage from 0 to VT0, it will be having a cutoff region. Once we are increasing further, okay, at that time, once we are increasing the gate voltage, what will happen, this voltage, so if we draw the transfer curve, this is VGS with respect to output. Okay, so with respect to output, if we plot the VGS, the output curve will be similar to this. Okay, so once we are applying the low VT, that is gate voltage, that is below your threshold voltage, it will be considered as a low logic. So once we are applying low logic, output will be high. So at that time, once gate voltage is low, output will be high. And at that time, the transistor is working in cutoff region. So there is no conduction. And this output, V output, will be equals to VDD. But the mode of operation of a particular MOSFET depends on their terminal voltages like VGS and VDS. So whatever VDS is there and what is VGS value is there, with respect to that, we can calculate the mode of operation of a MOSFET. Okay. So once we are increasing gate voltage, initially it was in cutoff region. And once we are increasing this gate voltage further more than your threshold voltage, what will happen? It will be either in saturation or in linear. Okay. There will be two options other than your cutoff region, because it is having a higher voltage, gate voltage, that is greater than threshold voltage. So we have to calculate in what particular mode it will be operating once we are increasing the gate voltage beyond your threshold voltage. So we will find out the different voltage values, that how this voltage values will be different. So the first is, it could be either linear mode or it could be in saturation mode. So to find out these modes, we need to find out VGS value, which is here given, it is greater than VT0, and VDS we have to find out. Okay, so whatever VDS value will be there, this is VDS value, your output voltage, VDS value. So VDS value will be, this VDS will be given by, this is your current. Okay, so this VDD minus VDS divided by R will be your current. Okay, some current will be flowing. So once we calculate the VDS, it will be given by, it will be like it will be VDD minus IR, or we can say ID into RL, or whatever load resistance is there, this RD we can call it, RD is there, suppose this is RD. Okay, so whatever VDS value will be VDD minus some voltage. So initially it was VDD, so this was the output, initially it was VDD, but once the current conduction starts, this VDD value will be dropping. So this VDS value, that is output, will be dropped by an amount of IR into RD. So this will be a drop voltage from VDD. So some lower voltage we will be getting. So we need to have, like, whether this VDS, whatever VDS is being obtained, is greater than VGS minus VT or not. So in this case, once we will be having some particular output, okay, so this output plus VT0. So once we have V input less than your V output plus VT0. Why? Because once VT0 is, suppose we have made it this way, so it will become V in minus VT0 is less than V out. And this V out is your VDS and V in your VGS. So it is VGS minus VT is less than this VDS. Here it implies, like, VDS for this mode of operation is greater than VGS minus VT0. So what it tells? It tells, like, the MOSFET is operating in saturation region. Okay, this is the condition for saturation. Okay, so from there we can see, like, if input voltage is ranging from VT0 to whatever output is there plus 1 VT, if this is the range of your input, at that range the MOSFET should be operating in saturation region. And then once we are increasing beyond that, that means your V input is greater than V out plus VT. So once we replace this VT0 on the left side, it will become V in minus VT0 is greater than or equal to V out. So from there we can see, in terms of VGS, it will be VGS minus VT0 is greater than or equal to VDS, because VDS is your V out. Okay, so this is the condition for linear mode of operation. So once we find out the value of VGS and VDS, we can predict in what particular mode the MOSFET is going to operate. So once we have identified the mode of operation of MOSFET with respect to the input voltage, we will be going to find out the relation. What will be the relation of different voltage and their different critical voltage parameters. Okay. So this is your voltage transfer curve for a resistive load inverter. So we in this there are different critical voltage points we need to find out, like VOH we need to find out, we need to find out VIL, we need to find out VIH, and we need to find out VOL. So these are the voltage points, and these voltages will be helped will help in finding the noise margin. So we will be we will be finding out the noise margin with respect to these critical voltages. We need to find out noise margin. So by using the different mode of operation of the MOSFET, we will find these what critical voltage points, and then with respect to that we will calculate the noise margin. So our main motive here is to find out the noise margins. Okay, so one by one we will be proceeding. So suppose we need to find out the VOH value. So in the voltage transfer curve, we will find like where VOH is there. So this VOH is the maximum output voltage. So this VOH will be your maximum possible output voltage that will be considered as logic 1. Okay. So we will be seeing like VOH is obtained when a particular gate input is there. This is input voltage. This input is your gate voltage. So whatever gate voltage we are providing at whatever low gate voltage we will be providing at that time, high output will be there. That high output will be your VOH. So this will be possible when the MOSFET is operating in cutoff region. Okay. So this is the region of cutoff region. So we will apply the gate voltage to the circuit so that the MOSFET is operating in cutoff region. At that time, whatever output voltage will be there, that will be your VOH value. Okay, so here the output can be given by VOH is equals to VDD minus RL into IR. Okay, so this is we can find out from the circuit, whatever circuit is there. So by using the KVL, we can find out the Vout, that is equals to VDS. So that is given by this equation. So whenever the input voltage is low, okay, that means it is less than threshold voltage. At that time, the MOSFET will be turned off and it will be working in cutoff region. So once the MOSFET is working in cutoff region, ID or the IR, the current through the drain drain of terminal of the MOSFET, or current through the resistor will be zero. So from there, once we will be putting ID equals to zero, RD or IR equals to zero, this term will become to zero. Okay, so this V output will be equals to, so your V output will be equals to VOH. So at that time, whatever output will be there, once the input voltage is low, that output will be equals to VOH, and that will be equals to VDD. Okay, so here we can find like VOH value will be equals to VDD value. Okay, the next point we need to find out is the VOL. So VOL, by definition, we call it is, this is the minimum output voltage. This is minimum output voltage when the output logic can be considered as the logic zero. Okay, and this will be obtained once we have applied the high input voltage. Okay, so to calculate the output low voltage, that is VOL, we assume that the input voltage is equals to VOH. So whenever the input voltage is equals to VOH value, that is V input is equals to VOH is equals to VOH, because we are having like VOH is equals to VDD. So once the input voltage is equals to VOH or VDD, at that time whatever mode of operation will be there for MOS transistors, based on that we will be finding out the VOL. So in this case, when V input is greater than or V input is equals to VDD at that time, since V input minus VT0 will be greater than V output. Okay, this is the case because when V input is equals to VDD, to find out whether the transistor is working in what particular mode, we need to find out V in minus VT0. So we will be subtracting this. So VDD, because input is VDD, minus VT0. So when VDD is being some VT0 is being subtracted from VT VDD, it will always be less than your VDD VDD value, or whatever output is there, this output will always be this VDD minus VT0 will be greater than output, because this is a high output and the high input, and this high input, for high input the output will be low. So whatever low output will be there, that will always be less than VDD minus some threshold voltage value, because we are providing for inverter. Okay, so if we are providing a high input logic, then output will be low. So this low will always be less than, okay, less than VDD minus VT. So it will be VDD minus VT will be greater than your V output. Okay, so because VDD is a high logic, so output will be low. So output will definitely be low once we are reducing even the VT0 also. Okay, so at that case, when output is low, that means your output is here VDS. So once VDS is less than this one, so we can call it like it is working in a linear region. So once the transistor is working in linear region, we will be finding out the IR. So IR is equals to ID, and if the transistor is working in linear region, this ID will be equals to ID linear mode. Okay, so here the linear mode equation of the MOSFET will be used in this formula. Okay, so this is like IR is equals to, from the previous this equation, V output is equals to VDD minus I RL into IR. So IR will be given by VDD minus V out divided by RL. So this IR is your drain current. Drain current when transistor is working in linear mode. So this VDD minus V out. So VDD minus V out at this time, when high input is applied, V output will equals to VOL. We will be replacing it by VOL. And divided by RL is equals to IR, R will be equals to IT, ID which is working in linear region. So for linear region, the equation of current is given by KN by 2 into VGS. So VGS is equals to here VDD, VGS, because V input is equals to VDD is equals to VGS minus VT into, this is VDS. So this will be VDS. And VDS is your V output. V output is equals to VDS, and VDS is equals to VOL here. So this will be equals to VOL minus VOL square. Okay. So this VDS is equals to your VGS is equals to VE. Okay. So after replacing all the parameters, what we have seen here and all other, it will be written like this. So this will be your equation. After solving this for VOL, we can solve this equation to find out the VOL, and finally we can get, this will be the final expression of VOL. Okay, so once we know the mode of operation of a MOSFET, we can just directly use the current equation. Whatever mode of operation MOSFET is working, we can use that current equation, and that current equation will directly derive the particular whatever voltage we are required. Are these voltages points, these four voltage points like VOH, VOL, VIL and VIH are called critical voltage points or critical voltages. Okay, so why these are critical voltages? Because they are important voltages that defines the noise immunity of a particular circuit. So the next point we will need to find out is VIL. So this VIL is by using just to, once you want to imagine these values, what VIL is actually, you need to remember the VI or you can say transfer characteristics. Okay, so at there, when this is the minus one slope, at that time whatever input voltage is, that is defined as VIL. So this VIL is the maximum input voltage when it is considered as logic zero. Okay, so any voltage ranging from zero to VIL will be considered as logic zero. Okay, in case of input voltage. Okay, so this is VIL is the maximum input voltage when logic is considered to be logic zero. So by definition, VIL is the smaller of the two input voltage values at which the slope of the voltage transfer curve becomes equals to minus one. So at this point, voltage transfer curve is having a minus one slope, or at that point, these two points, out of these two, the minimum value is considered as VIL value. Okay, this is here dV out by dV in is equals to minus one. So we need to use this concept. This will be concept will be used for finding out your VIL. The simple inspection of voltage transfer curve, that when the input is equals to VIL, the output voltage is slightly smaller than VOH. So this VIL, whenever VIL will be applied, this is your VOH value. At that time, the output voltage will be slightly lower than VOH value. Okay, so in that case, the output will be equals to V input minus VT0. So V output will be greater than V input minus VT0. This is the case because the output will be just slightly lower than the VOH, that is the highest voltage, output voltage. So this V output will be higher than this V input minus VT0. So this is V input is VGS minus VT0. So when V out, that is VDS, is greater than VGS minus VT0, that means the MOSFET is operating in saturation region. So from there, we need to find the same saturation current equation. So we need to find out ID saturation, and we need to replace this ID saturation by IR, whatever resistance current is flowing through the resistor value, that will be your ID saturation. So at that time, VDD minus V out divided by RL will be equals to Kn by 2 V input minus VT0 to the power 2. So this is your ID saturation, and this is equals to IR also. Okay, so from there, what we can do is we need to find out the V output divided by Vin, because at VIL input, dV out by dV in is equals to minus 1. So we will be differentiating this complete equation with respect to input voltage, and whenever dV out by dV in will be there, we will be replacing it by minus one. So we will differentiate it. So this is a constant, so it will be zero, and this term will become minus one by RL into dV in divided by dV in, dV out by dV in is equals to Kn. And to differentiate this, it will become 2 into V in minus VT0, and this V in once will be differentiated and it will be multiplied by 1, and this will be constant equals to 0. So this will be the after differentiation we will get this value. So what we will do is we will replace this dV out by dV in is equals to minus 1. Okay, so once we will replace this dV out by dV in is equals to minus 1, at that time your V input should be equals to VIL value. So once we will put these two values into this equation, we will find the VIL is given by VT0 plus 1 by Kn into RL. Okay, so what is here Kn? What is Kn? This is called transconductance parameter. Okay, so this is your transconductance parameter, and it depends on mu n COx. Okay, and W by, okay, So this will be transconductance parameter will be from there. Also, you can find like what is Kn, because the complete equation is equals to mu n cox by 2 w by l. Okay, so this mu n cox w by l will be considered as your Kn value. Okay, transconductance parameters. Okay, so once we have find out vil, we will similarly find out vih. Okay, so in case of vih, we will again recall the voltage transfer curve, that is VTC. So from there, the at vih value, that is vih is the minimum input voltage when input logic is considered logic 1. So this VIH is the minimum input voltage that can be considered as logic 1. Okay, at that time also the slope of this voltage transfer curve will be equals to minus 1. Okay, and when the input voltage is equals to VIH, the output voltage is only slightly larger than the output low voltage. So by using the voltage transfer curve, we can see, like, suppose this is your VOL value. So at the slope value will be somewhere at this point. This will be VIH. So this will be minus one slope. So this at a VIH value, the output voltage will be slightly greater than your VOL value. Okay, so it is slightly greater than VOL, means it is having a low voltage. The output will be like a low logic value. Okay, it will be similar to that. Okay, because it is closer to VOL. So when output is low, that means VGS minus VT should be greater than VDS, or in other terms we can call it like V input minus VT0 should be greater than V output. Okay, so when the input is VIH at this point, this condition will be satisfied, like V input minus VT0 will be greater than V output. So this condition says like your MOSFET will be working in linear mode. Okay, so once the MOSFET is working in linear mode, then we have to use the linear mode current flowing through the transistor. Once the linear mode current is flowing through the transistor, the same current will be flowing through the resistor also. So from the same equation, the beginning equation, that is VDD minus Vout divided by RL, must be equals to IR, and this IR will be equals to ID linear mode. So whatever linear mode current is there, so this is your linear mode current equation. So we will be replacing IR with linear mode current equation, and again we have to differentiate it. We need to differentiate it, okay, with respect to V input. So after differentiation, we will be finding out dV out divided by dV in, and we will again replace it by minus one. Okay, so once we will replace it by minus one, at that time V input will be equals to VIH value. Okay, so we will be differentiating this equation, and once we have differentiated, we will be replacing all the points where dV out by dV in is coming in the differentiation. We will be putting it to minus one, and whenever V input is coming, this V input will be replaced by VIH. So after replacing, finally we will get the VIH value. Okay, so this VIH value from there can calculate is this one. Okay, so once we have put the value, we can find out the VIH value. So one more thing, like this VIH is written in terms of V output. Okay, so this is written in terms of V output. So if we want to replace or write this VIH, that is only dependent on constant parameters, not this voltage. So what we will be doing is we will be putting this VIH value into the equation, the previous equation with the current. So this equation was there, In this equation, V input will be retained as this value, and that will be in terms of V output. So from there we can find out the V output is equals to this one, and with respect to this V out, again we will be replacing it into this equation, and finally we will be getting this VIHS, this value. So this is the value that is having dependence on independent parameters. Okay, like threshold voltage, it does not depend on any other parameters. And similarly, VDD will be constant, and RL will be constant, and RL again will be constant. This KN and this KN value will be transconductance parameter that is given by mu n COX W by L. That will be, this term will be constant. Okay, this will be a constant value, but this will be a variable that can be changed as the designer wants. So based on the circuit designer, WL ratio, WL values can be changed to find out a different variation in VIH value. Okay, so once we have find it out all the circuit components, so like we have just find out the four critical voltages. So we have find out VOH value, VOL value, VIL and VIH. So once we have find out all these values, what we can do is like, we can have again the draw the points. So suppose this is your input voltage and this is the graph of your output voltage. This will be your VDD. So this will be VIL, this will be VIH, and VOL value will be here. This will be your VOL, and your VOH value will be this one, and this is your VDD, and this is your VOH. Okay, so whatever the difference is there between these two, and whatever difference between these two is there, this is called noise margin H for high, and this is noise margin for low. So we will be finding the noise margin for low logic. So noise margin for low logic will be VIL minus VOL, and noise margin for high logic will be equals to VOH minus VIH. Okay, so from there we can see like whatever noise margin for low and noise margin for high is there, the final overall noise margin is given by minimum of these two, noise margin low and noise margin high. So out of these two noise margin low values and noise margin high values, out of these two, what will be the minimum value that will be considered as your noise margin of that particular circuit? Okay, and one thing we can notice, like if VIL value, so whatever VIL value is there, suppose this VIL value is slightly higher than the current value whatever we have obtained. So suppose instead of this value, this VIL is up to this level. Okay, and this, okay, so let's consider only one point. So VIL we have suppose increased from this value to this value, so we will go to the VIL expression. Okay, so this is the expression of your VIL. So VIL should be depending on VT0 and the term that is 1 upon KN into RL. Okay, so this for a particular circuit, once the circuit is implemented, this RL will be a constant value and this VT0 will also be constant. Okay, so the only parameter that can be changed to change this VIL value will be depending on this KN value, that is called your transconductance parameter value. So this KN value depends on mu n COX and W by L. Okay, so once we put this value, so from there VIL will be equals to VT0 plus 1 upon this KN, we will replace it, so it will be mu n COx by 2 comes to upper side and L will be there and it will be W into RL. Okay, so this will be the total parameters. So this parameter mu n and COx is also like not variable for a designer. So for a designer, the only parameter that can be changed is L value and W value. Okay, so length and width. So to increase this VIL, what we need to have is we have to increase L value. Okay, so to increase this VIL value, we have to increase L value, the length of a transistor, or we need to decrease, okay, this W value. So once we are going to increase this L value or we are decreasing this W value, your VIL value will be increased. Okay, so the role of a designer comes here. Once you have find out the relation, like what will the relation between the VIL and the different variables that can be set by the designer. So here the only variable is length and width. So once the designer knows that the relation between the VIL and length and width is similar to this, like L is directly proportional to VIL and W is inversely proportional to VIL, then to increase VIL, we have to set the parameters of these two values similar to this. Okay, we need to increase the L value and we need to decrease the W value. So based on our specification, suppose a specification of an inverter is given like you need to have VIL value is equals to 2 volt. Okay, suppose this is the specification given, and after calculation, whatever configuration you have set, you have find like VIL value is coming out to be 1.8 volt. Okay, so once the VIL value is coming out to be 1.8 volt and you and in the specification it was given like it should be 2 volt. So to make it 2 volt, what we need to do is we need to set the parameters of L and W with respect to that. We have to increase L value or we have to decrease this W value, or we can do both at the same time. Okay, but our motive should be to have VIL equals to 2 volt. So based on the specification, we need to change WIL values to get our desired specification. Okay, so this is how we need to think for different equations like similar to this. Suppose this is VIH value. So to have, okay, so just why we are increasing this VIL value. Okay, so why we are going to have a higher VIL value? What is the advantage of having higher VIL value? So just we will see, like once VIL is increased to this value, then the noise margin at the low logic will be new noise margin will be this one. So this range or this gap is increased. So once it is having higher gap, that means the noise margin will be high. If the noise margin is high, then that transistors or that circuit will be having very less effect of the noise on the circuit. So similarly, suppose we need to have a noise independent circuit, then what we need to do is we need to increase this VIH also, and this VOS should be decreased. So this should be moving to this direction and this should be moving to this direction. Similarly, VOL value should be moving towards the zero. Once the VOL is moving towards the zero and VOH is moving towards the VDD, we will be getting like we will get maximum width of noise margin low logic and similarly the noise margin high logic. Once we have the maximum width of these two, noise margin for high and noise margin for low, then the noise margin, overall noise margin will be high. Okay, so from there we can think of the noise margin, like how the transistor sizing can affect. So based on the expressions that we have got, so if this circuit is a resistive load, okay, so this is resistive load. So in case of resistive load, this was the relation, But in case of some other type of loads, the relation of VIH and VIL will be something different. So we need to have a relation, whatever the relation is coming out to be based on the configuration of the circuit. We will be finding out the relation. Once we have found out the relation, we can correlate like what is the noise margin required and how we can set it. Okay, so this is how the circuit designers work. Okay, so one more point we will be seeing, like in resistive load inverters, what is the role of Rn into RL, Kn into RL? Because in all the critical voltage points, Kn RL is one of the, you can say, variable points. Kn RL here is also is depending on based on these values, IL is going to work change. Okay, so here also in case of VOL, so in case of VOL value also Kn RL is a parameter that is affecting VOH value, but VDD is equals to VDD, VOH is equals to VDD. So out of four, three critical voltages are having dependence or Kn RL. So there is an example. Suppose if VDD is 5 volt and VT0 is 1 volt, then the Kn RL value we are going to change, like we are increasing the Kn and RL value. We are increasing. So once we are increasing, we can see like once the Kn RL value is being increased, the curve of the inverter, suppose this is the ideal one. Okay. Suppose this is the ideal curve. Okay, so suppose this is the ideal curve. So we can see like once the slope is steep, so it is slope is very high. So at that time, the voltage transfer curve will be considered as an closer to ideal. So once we are increasing, we are getting a steeper curve. So this curve is being steep, more becomes more steeper once the Kn RL value is being increased. So based on the value, we can see like once we are increasing, the slope of this voltage transfer curve is being closer to your ideal value. Okay. So this is how we can correlate the variation of this transconductance parameter into RL term with respect to different values. Okay. So we'll close for the day. Up to here, if anyone is having any doubt, you can ask. Yes,